Today we're going to take a look at a version of Otzi the Iceman's Firekit. Now Otzi was found in 1991 on the border of Austria and Italy in the Otzi Alps, and he's a 5,300-year-old ice mummy. Now, what's important about him isn't just the age, but the good state of preservation of his body, and also that most of his tools and clothing were still generally intact with the body. And so they found with him a belt going around his waist, similar to this that I have. The main difference is that Otzi wore his next to the skin and had a loincloth and leggings on, almost an American Indian style, and basically had the loincloth cup up under and then over his fire kit, and under it and over it in the back also. In the front, there's a pouch. His didn't have this little lip, but I keep it on there for some extra protection over the stuff that I have kept in here. With Otzi, it just naturally closed, and with that loincloth over there, the idea was that it would help keep his equipment a little bit drier. As I take this off, you can see that I have it doubled. And this is a little bit longer than his. And his was actually made out of calf leather, but this is brain tan. It's been stained with walnuts to give it a little bit darker color. Let's take a look and see what's inside of it. You can see that this belt is basically just a tube with this little flap. And inside of it, I have some tinder from cedar, in the inner bark of a cedar. I have a little buckskin pouch, and inside of this I have tinder fungus, which we're not going to use, but it's off of birch trees. But I also have some patches of amadou. Now this is a European fungus, and actually they use it for some clothing over there. It's mainly used to dry fishing flies these days. But this is what we're actually going to get our fire started on. You can see that it's real flexible. It can get wet and it can be dried out. So that's what we use to get our fire started. I also have my striker and some extra pieces of flint. Now on Otzi, they found what they considered a knife shaped about like this, a little bit longer and at an angle. Originally they thought it was a broken knife. Some people speculate, though, because of where it was located and what equipment it was located around, that it may have been a striker for starting fires. And this is what we're going to use. Basically, it's just a handle with some rawhide hafting on a flint chisel, basically. And then also, we have an iron pyrite. This is the stuff that's known as fool's gold, and it has iron in it. This one is actually from England, I think around Dover. And so what we're going to do is kind of like the same principle as flint and steel, but striking a piece of flint against a piece of steel and getting sparks from it. Since this has iron in it, we'll strike this flint against it, get sparks, and that's what'll start our fire. So we're going to make our little bird's nest out of our tinder, make sure it's ready to go once we get our spark. And of course, if I was actually starting a fire, I'd have kindling and wood ready to go to put on it. With our amadou, we're going to take a little patch of this. And scrape up a little bit of shavings and rough that up so that hopefully it'll be able to catch a spark a little bit easier.
You see that little pile there? We'll take our pyrite and our striker and start striking it. It's a little bright to be able to tell whether I'm getting any sparks off of it or not, but in a second you'll be able to get to see some smoke coming out down here. That'll mean that we have gotten a spark. And there's our spark. See a little bit of smoke coming out of there. I'm going to tear off this little corner. And put it up here in our bird's nest. Gently blow up into it. And there's your fire. And that's how they started fire in Europe 5,300 years ago. This isn't a method that I would prefer to depend on if I had to out in the woods to start a fire, but if you're interested in ancient technology, it's a good one to experiment with. To do all this, you'll need to make your belt, and there's different designs for this belt, but basically it's just a tube with that little pouch. For starting your fire, you need the amadou. And the only place I know of to get this is through fly fishing suppliers. As I said, they used it to dry out their flies after fishing, and actually it's fairly expensive, but as you can see, it works. Frankly, you could probably get away with using charcoal, as I've shown in another video, but the only problem with that is that, as you can see from the technique of striking it, you're most likely going to tear up that char cloth an awful lot. You'll need some kind of a striker or pieces of flint, and frankly I think that just the flake of flint works pretty much just as well as the striker. The pyrite, good luck with your experimenting.